Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum and good afternoon to all distinguished guests. Firstly, I must thank the International Strategy Institute for inviting me here today to deliver the special luncheon address at the 4th Malaysia Tax Policy Forum. I would also like to take this opportunity to thank all the taxpayers. All of you here for your contribution to our tax collection last year. In 2023, we were able to achieve a record-breaking tax collection of 183 billion, our highest collection thus far. In light of this forum theme, bridging the taxation divide, building a sustainable future for Malaysia, I'll start off with Hasir's journey towards Tax Administration 3.0 and how it relates to other main initiatives this year, like e-invoicing and also TCGF. Ladies and gentlemen, it's important for Hasir to keep pace with the rapid development of technologies these days by digitalizing our tax administration. Therefore, one of our core strategies is to also leverage on technology so that taxation becomes an intrinsic part of a taxpayer's digital ecosystem. This is in line with the Tax Administration 3.0 initiative led by the Organization for Economic Cooperation and Development, OECD, that aims to help tax administration modernize and adapt to the changing tax landscape. The initiative recognizes the need for tax authorities to transform operations and processes to keep pace with advancement in technology and changes in taxpayer behavior. Our focus under the Tax Administration 3.0 initiative is on four key areas. The first area is on digital transformation, harnessing technology and data to enhance tax compliance and improve efficiency in administration through advanced data analytics and artificial intelligence automation tools. Second, taxpayer services and compliance. These emphasize the importance of providing user-friendly taxpayer services, simplifying compliance requirements, and promoting voluntary compliance through improved communication and guidance. Thirdly, cooperative compliance, building collaborative relationship between tax administration and taxpayer to foster mutual trust and cooperation. And finally, international cooperation, working together globally with other tax administration to combat tax evasion, share best practices, and ensure a level playing field for cross-border businesses. As taxpayers and the whole economy go increasingly digital, opportunities arise for the use of digital data and analytical tools. This digital transformation, Tax Administration 3.0, significantly improved the effectiveness of compliance activity by increasing transparency, using data to identify gaps, and easing administrative burdens. The report by the OECD Forum on Tax Administration in 2020 highlights that as the tax landscape evolved towards a digital framework, Tax Administration 3.0 enabled more efficient monitoring and enforcement of tax compliance, helping to identify potential tax gaps, detect irregularity, leaving minimal possibility for tax leakages and evasion. In a nutshell, Tax Administration 3.0, simplify tax processes, and use real-time data to identify non-compliance issues in the tax system, ultimately strengthening revenue collection and creating a fair ecosystem. This is in line with Hasil transformation agenda this year, particularly with the implementation of e-invoicing to integrate the system used by taxpayers as part of their daily lives and business. Ladies and gentlemen, on e-invoicing, as I believe all of you must be aware, the implementation of e-invoice in stages will begin on 1st of August 2024, where phase one of the implementation will involve about 5,000 taxpayers. The number one concern of my taxpayer is the approaching timeline. We have received a number of requests for extension of time, but we are going to deal with this on a case-to-case basis. Companies that are facing issues can approach us or contact us to highlight the issues that they are facing. We will look into the issues and see where we can assist or give leniency or concession to the case. Although the ultimate aim is for e-invoice to be issued for each transaction, at the moment, we allow the issuance of consolidated invoice with bare minimum requirement for all, except for 7 industries. Probably has been covered this morning on the topic of e-invoice. The first industry will be automotive, in respect of sale of any motor vehicle. Second industry will be aviation, sale of flight ticket and private charter, luxury goods and jewelry, construction, wholesalers and retailers of construction materials, licensed betting and gaming, payment to agent, dealers and distributors. For these 7 activities, they are required to prepare e-invoice for each transaction. With a consolidated invoice, taxpayer can combine all their transactions in a month and submit the e-invoice by the 7th day of the following month. The reason why we focus on this 7 industry is to ensure e-invoice for each transaction is to ensure higher compliance, as many taxpayers in this industry are part of the grey economy and not within our tax base. We are also working towards introducing more simplified approaches to ease the implementation of e-invoice, particularly for MSME. Among the solutions that will be introduced, we're going to introduce free My Invoice portal and app that can be used by MSME. This portal is accessible to all taxpayers who need to issue e-invoice. We are going to provide QR code for each taxpayer so that it will be easier to share their information when making a purchase. We're going to have a free digital point of sale app which can be used by MSME that is equipped with basic e-invoice features. The idea of this app is that it can automatically generate e-invoice for MSME through the app. For platform service provider, Shopee, Grab, Lazada, the platform providers we use will issue e-invoice on behalf of merchant upon buyer request. There will be issuance of e-invoice via payment network provider, and MSME, we only need to fulfill 6 out of 55 data fields and other fields will be pre-filled. It is also important to note that it is not mandatory for MSME to issue e-invoice when requested, and we allow the issuance of consolidated e-invoice. Currently, under the law, there is no requirement for tax claim to be substantiated with an e-invoice, as normal receipts are still acceptable. They have also been concerned about the number of updates to our guidelines. Let me assure you that the guidelines that we have introduced are updated based on the issue raised and discussed with the industry. The updates do not introduce an entirely new approach to the implementation of e-invoice. Many are also worried about the penalty that may be imposed under the law. A penalty of RM200 to RM2,000 may be imposed for failure to issue an invoice. However, Hasil will look into each case before imposing any penalty. What we want on taxpayer part is to see their readiness, some form of preparation to comply with the requirement of the invoice. At the moment, Hasil is working on increasing awareness and education, especially towards taxpayer in phase 2 and phase 3 of the implementation. More engagement and promotion of e-invoicing will be conducted. Ladies and gentlemen, one of the areas on Tax Administration 3.0 is on corporative compliance. As part of Hasil's effort to increase tax compliance through a cooperative compliance approach, we have introduced the TCGF program, where it aims to build a better relationship with taxpayer based on trust and mutual understanding. TCG is basically a control mechanism within an organization that identifies, assess tax risks, and establish action to mitigate such risks. TCGF set out the RBM expectation on the application of the principle of tax corporate governance within an organization setting. The Organization of Economic Cooperation and Development, OECD, through its publication on cooperative tax compliance, identified the six principles in developing a good TCGF. One is tax strategy established. Secondly, applied comprehensively. Thirdly, responsibility assigned. Fourthly, governance documented. Testing performed. And finally, assurance provided. TCG aims to help organizations understand the focus area Hasil concerning tax corporate governance to enable business to develop or improve an organization tax governance and internal control framework, promote tax compliance and reduce tax risks, test the robustness of an organization framework, understand how to demonstrate the operational effectiveness of an organization key internal control to its provider stakeholders, including the RBM, and to ensure that financial, regulatory, and reputational risks associated with taxation are fully identified and evaluated. TCG is suitable for all sizes and types of businesses that give priorities and resources to corporate governance matters. Investors are increasingly looking at how businesses manage and report tax and have increased expectation for clear and transparent tax reporting and strong tax governance. In light of this, qualified public companies
we'll bring you a new mic. Even the mic is hungry.
Hello. Okay, in light of this, qualified public listed companies are strongly encouraged to actively participate in the program. Can you hear me? Okay? Okay. Organizations that fulfill the following criteria are invited to join the TCG program. Large companies, public listed, government-linked companies, state-owned enterprise with turnover of 100 million and above. Compliant taxpayer, where the return form submission and taxpayer are in order, and companies with established tax control framework. Our pilot project, which was launched in 2022, has been a success, where 7 companies will be awarded with the TCG certificate this month. Ladies and gentlemen, the Special Voluntary Disclosure Program 2.0, SVDP 2.0, just ended on the 31st of May 2024. The target set were participation by 50,000 taxpayers and 1 billion in additional tax. We are happy that we have surpassed the target. As at 31st of May 2024, 64,198 taxpayers have participated in the program, and the amount of assessment raised is RM1.1 billion ringgit. Under SVDP 2.0, the penalty offered was 0%, and the commitment that hasil will not audit the years that correspond to the voluntary disclosure. We will ensure that this commitment is upheld. Now that SVDP 2.0 has ended, the normal penalty rates under the tax audit framework will apply. However, taxpayer may still make a voluntary disclosure to us, but it will be subjected to a penalty of 15%. Ladies and gentlemen, the tax to GDP ratio reflecting direct tax has been a modest uptick compared to the previous year. In 2023, we achieved a ratio of 9.91%, up from 9.80% in 2022. Probably I need to stop for lunch already. While this improvement is encouraging, it is important to note that our performance still lags considerably behind the OECD reported percentage at around 34.1%, which encompasses both direct and indirect tax collection. Even though our 9.91% direct tax to GDP ratio is the highest among ASEAN countries, there is still significant potential for us to explore and enhance the nation tax collection effort until we attain the optimal ratio for a country. Simultaneously, we are mindful of the uncertainty surrounding the global economy, expected to register moderate growth after a period of recession. The International Monetary Fund forecasts global growth prospect to be just 3% in 2024. This year, the tax collection target has been set at RM197 billion. The GDP growth projected to range between 4 to 5% in 2024. Supported by robust domestic demand and considering the moderate impact of global growth challenges. This growth will also be bolstered by the implementation of initiatives outlined in the new National Energy Transition Roadmap, the new Industrial Master Plan 2030, and the midterm review of the 12th Malaysian Plan. In line with the continued emphasis from Yang Amat Berhormat Prime Minister that tax leakages need to be dealt with firmly, Hasil main approach for 2024 is to increase its compliance activity. We will be increasing our enforcement activities now that the program is over. Our focus will be incentive cases, group companies, cross-border transaction, domestic transfer pricing, aggressive tax planning, online transaction, government contracts, and Labuan entities. This year, we have also recently established a new strategic compliance branch that will focus on high profile cases, high net worth individual, shadow economy, illegal immigrants, and offshore accounts. Ladies and gentlemen, while we are leveraging on technology, our tax enforcement activities will continue as data shows that there are still a lot of leakages that need to be addressed. Our main goal ultimately is to increase tax literacy and also voluntary compliance. To achieve this, we cannot do it alone, and we need the support of all parties to play their part. Together, we can build a better and sustainable Malaysia. Thank you.